These are things that you must know about Bay Area home lending. This is the first step that needs to be done before looking for a home. You want to understand what your loan ceiling is, and this is what I personally call a hard ceiling. There isn't much of a purpose of looking at properties above this amount unless you're able to get some sort of gift money or financial support from others. Nevertheless, there are a lot of lenders and loan programs out there, so what do you do? Before we begin, smash that like button, hit subscribe, and click on the little bell. That way you'll be notified every time I release a new video and it doesn't get lost in the YouTube algorithm. Let's begin. Banks constantly change their guidelines and take turns being the most competitive, but there are a few things to be aware of. I do what I can personally to constantly monitor and track the strengths and weaknesses of each bank so that my clients can get an advantage. There are two common types of loan programs. There is typically a 30-year fixed rate or an adjustable rate mortgage or an ARM rate. Many people decide between the two based on how they feel about interest rates changing in the future and their time horizon of owning the property itself. If you are certain that you'll be using the home as a trade-up or plan to sell within 5 to 7 years, many people opt for the ARM rate and save money on their monthly payments. ARM rates, adjustable rate mortgages, are typically lower by 0.25% to 0.5% from a 30-year fixed amount. When it comes to home purchases that require at least a $250,000 down payment, Wells Fargo is currently very hard to beat. They have a program called Assets Under Management, which allows clients to buy down rates with money that they would have used for a down payment anyways. Other private client programs require the money to stay in the account after the transaction takes place. So this is a huge competitive advantage for those that are familiar with that program that Wells Fargo has to offer. Another program is physician loans, especially tied with companies like Kaiser, has some of the best programs out there. Depending on what kind of offer you received from your local Kaiser, many physicians at Kaiser have down payment assistance programs where Kaiser Permanente covers 10% of your down payments. Physicians without support from their company have loans that can buy with 5% down, will have no mortgage insurance, and can buy up to $1.2 million. What mortgage insurance is an extra monthly cost that you would pay if you don't have enough skin in the game initially for the home. So you may be thinking, wait a second, if Kaiser can cover 10% and a standard physician loan requires 5%, does this mean I don't need to put any money down? Bingo. You can reach out to me and learn more about this process, but you should note this for all of your physician friends. There isn't much of an excuse not to be a homeowner, even if you're a brand new physician. BBVA has some of the best programs for this right now. And if you're a first-time home buyer, you don't have to buy with 20% down. That's a misconception. There are plenty of programs for as low as 3.5% down for everyone to take advantage of. Now, there is a max of a purchase amount of $765,000, but there are plenty of properties all throughout the Bay Area to get in this category. So people ask me, but there is mortgage insurance. The question is, so what? It's always better to get into the home ownership side of the table than as a renter, where that is a guaranteed sunk cost. As to the value of a home rises over time, you have the option to refinance out of the PMI, since the PMI is needed due to having initially very little equity or skin in the game. It also accelerates you and frees up that capital to be able to do other things with your money. Mortgage breakers are great candidates for this, and they do tend to be more flexible than banks in terms of your options. All of these are great options because you are leveraging what we have right now as historic record low interest rates and getting out of the rental space. I have personally vetted and have great lending partners, as very much like the realtor side of the business, there are a lot of loan offices out there. And even though the companies have their guidelines, they are not and certainly not all equal from a knowledge perspective, for communication, and from a work ethic perspective. If you or anyone you know is considering to buy, sell, or invest in the Bay Area, let's talk. I'm never too busy to be introduced, and I have helped several clients from these videos itself. I look forward to seeing you at the next one. Bye now.
Thank
Thanks for making it to the very end of my YouTube video. If you like the content, please hit that subscribe button. Make sure you hit that little bell as well, since it'll give you notifications of when my next episode is. If you know of anyone that is considering to buy or sell a home here in the Bay Area, I'm never too busy to help more people. Always welcome to have a conversation, regardless if you're ready to go right now or if you wanted to buy 5 years later. Click on that calendar link and then you'll be able to book an appointment with me and love to have a conversation about your situation. In the meantime, I also do have a monthly newsletter, so feel free to hit that link below and then you'll be able to get my updates, personal updates that I write once a month in terms of what is going on with the market and some of my latest activities. Hope to see you at the next one. Thank you.